Welcome to Seed to Life. I hope you're doing well and keeping safe. Vaccination is going on at full speed in many countries, and despite that, COVID situation is not completely under control. And as there is a shortage of medicine, vaccines, supplies like oxygen cylinders and ventilators, many people are desperately looking for alternative medicines. For the past 2 days, one message is circulating on social media. It is a herbal remedy made up of camphor, cloves, eucalyptus oil and ajwain seeds or carom seeds. The message recommends to inhale the heated mix of these medicines several times a day. All the ingredients are tied in a small cloth called potli and it is heated on a dry pan. The message claims that inhaling this mix increases oxygen level in the blood. Many of my friends and relatives are forwarding such messages and they have started doing it already. They do not have COVID, but they are still doing it as a preventive measure. When I read this, the warning bells rang in my mind. I recently made one video on camphor trees while I got a new tree for myself. And that is when I found out how toxic and dangerous camphor can be if used improperly. So, I decided to do a little research to find out the truth behind it, and I'm going to share it with you today. I'm going to share both the positive and negative aspects of each of these ingredients in short. You can use the reference links that I post in the description to find out more about these medicines. So, let's begin. We will start with camphor first. Camphor that we buy from stores can be obtained either natural way from camphor laurel trees or synthetically in factories. Natural camphor is not very famous because it is very easy to make camphor artificially. And more importantly, making camphor from trees requires cutting down old trees. So we can assume that to get camphor from trees, the tree has to be at least 10 years old. But usually much older trees are cut down in this process. These old trees are cut down and their trunk is peeled off to get the clean inner wood. The wood is then cut into small pieces or wood chips, and these wood chips undergo a distillation process. What it means is that the wood chips are boiled and the camphor mixed steam is moved to another water filled pot using a hollow pipe, and the steam is cooled down. When it cools down, the camphor particles, they solidify and float on the water. And these clumps are then collected and made into cubes or shells. And that is the camphor that we use. Camphor is an organic compound that is also found in some other trees of the laurel family, like East African camphor wood or camphor basil. Synthetically, it is made from the oil of turpentine. Now, let's look at the uses of camphor. Camphor is part of many medicines, including pain reliever ointments, balms, nasal decongestants, cough remedies, anti-itch creams. It relieves cough symptoms because of its antispasmodic effects. Now let's talk about camphor toxicity. Natural camphor is also called as D-camphor or dextrorotatory camphor, and L-camphor or levorotatory camphor is the synthetic one. Synthetic camphor shows higher toxicity compared to the natural one. It is really hard to know if the camphor is natural or not. I have these two types of camphor and one of them is edible, so I believe this is the natural form. And I'm not sure actually, since the label doesn't mention it. I believe this is the one that you are supposed to use for the remedy. Then there are cubes of synthetic camphor. Since many small manufacturing companies and not pharmaceutical companies are producing this camphor, I doubt that it is that easy to find pure natural camphor. And as we learned that it can only be made from mature trees, I doubt that that many trees are still available to cut down and make camphor. So if you decide to use camphor for medicinal use, then it is advisable to get an approved medicine with the proper dosage and warning mentioned on the label. Accidentally or purposely eating camphor, smelling it or even applying it on the body can result in camphor toxicity because it gets absorbed very easily into the body. In fact, it is very common. Camphor also passes through the placental barrier, so pregnant and lactating women should avoid using and ingesting camphor containing products. The same applies to infants. Camphor containing products should not be used for children as they can cause convulsions that too just in a few minutes after ingestion or overdose. One of the most common causes of intoxication is accidental ingestion. You can find the products such as balms, mothballs, cold relieving over-the-counter medicines easily available in our houses. Applying camphor containing ointments to children's noses is also dangerous. Coming on to the eucalyptus oil. The leaves, fruits, and bark of the eucalyptus plant contains several phytochemical compounds. Eucalyptol is a major chemical that is found in high amounts. Eucalyptus oil is traditionally used as a remedy for various illnesses such as cold, cough, because of its antibacterial and antiseptic properties. It is also known to have some pain and fever reducing properties. Eucalyptus oil is also known to have cytotoxic effects on the cells, so it is possibly useful to control abnormal cell growth that happens in tumors and cancers. But again, you have to remember that most of these studies are only non-clinical, and the experiments, if they are done only on animals, so we don't have any solid information to rely on. I always say that anything in excess is toxic. If eucalyptus oil is consumed above a particular safe limit, then it can be toxic too. And even though several resources talk about toxicity, I couldn't find very accurate information about the exact toxic dose. The toxic symptoms of eucalyptus oil start quickly after the overdose. They start with a burning sensation in the mouth and throat, stomach ache, and vomiting. Initially, when the brain and the nervous system are affected, it causes the inability to stand, lack of coordination, so the person may appear drunk and disoriented or confused. It is followed by loss of consciousness, occurring in about 10 to 15 minutes. Convulsions are more common in children. Death usually happens after a dose of 30 ml, but it can also happen after taking much lower doses. Let's talk about the third ingredient in the remedy, that are cloves. Clove spice or clove oil contains major constituent eugenol. You can find this valuable spice getting used in various cuisines, dental products, and even as an essential oil. It relieves headaches and mental fog. Clove oil is known to cure various infections and is very strong antioxidant. Clove has an antiplatelet effect, that means it prevents blood clotting. Clove can also be used as an expectorant or cough remedy. It also has pain relieving abilities. Now we saw the benefits, now let's look at the toxicity symptoms. Nowadays, many people suffer heart diseases and they're kept on antiplatelet medicines like aspirin. So overdose of clove containing products can further increase the chances of bleeding in some people. Cloves have caustic effects and they can burn the skin and mucosal layers. Ingestion of clove oil can cause poisoning to occur. Acute poisoning can cause loss of consciousness, coma, seizures, and liver failure. The last ingredient is ajwain or carom seeds. The herb ajwain is also an ancient medicinal herb, and it is not just used in different cuisine but also used as a traditional medicine. The main essential oil in ajwain is thymol. Ajwain is known to cure cough and respiratory diseases. It is also used for the treatment of many stomach and digestion problems. It reduces stomach pain due to gas trouble, improves appetite. It is traditionally used for the treatment of intestinal worms. There are many other claimed benefits of ajwain. Since carom seeds contain phytochemical thymol, I tried to find the toxic dose or side effects of thymol, but very limited information is available about its effects on human. But I know that thymol, probably the synthetic one, is widely used as a pesticide. We saw the claimed benefits of all these herbs and also saw the side effects and toxicity symptoms. Even though these herbs have some medicinal value and are traditionally being used for the treatment of cough and other respiratory problems, I couldn't find any specific study focused on their use in increasing the oxygen level of the body. They are primarily used as inhalers to relieve cough or as an expectorant, as we saw earlier. More importantly, there are no studies focusing on the effectiveness of these herbs when they are used together. However, there are several reports of poisoning caused by improper use of these herbal medicines. When a new medicine is approved and sold in the market, the company is first required to go through several steps of research, animal studies, and if found safe, then finally the clinical studies that includes many people. After the studies, when we finally purchase the medicine, manufacturers and prescribers inform us about the proper dosage, warn us about any other side effects, and also provide the helpline numbers in case of poisoning. When we start creating our own medicines at home, we do not know how much is safe to use. Especially with the ingredients like camphor, things can suddenly get ugly. It is dangerous to experiment with our health, especially at these times when even the hospitals are almost full at many places. Overall, the research on traditional medicines is very limited and not very expensive like it is for allopathy medicines. And even herbal medicines can have serious side effects. So it is up to you to decide what is safe for you. Thank you for watching, and I hope you find this video useful. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel Seed to Life and click on the bell icon to watch more such videos. Social media links are in the description. Thank you again. See you soon.